Well, first of all, I got diabetes, type 1 diabetes, when I was about 8 years old. And so I've been taking insulin for 50 years. I'm 58 right now. Since I've been an adult, it's been in pretty good control. But what happened was we saw the movie Food, Inc., my wife and I. We walked out of that movie, and she turned to me and said, I'm never going to eat any animal products again. And so that launched an investigation of, well, if you're going to be vegan, how do you eat a healthy vegan? We read the China study. We read Ettinger's or Esselstyn's book. You know, we also got some of McDougall's books. After a year of eating, you know, basically the McDougall diet for a year, and hardcore, no animal products, no milk, no eggs, none of that. I mean, when we went vegan, we never ate any of that stuff again. I mean, really, I'm very disciplined. And my doctor said that all my numbers, and they test a whole lot, you know, a whole lot of things with me as a diabetic, all the numbers were what a non-diabetic who was really healthy would be. I mean, very shortly after, you know, going 100% vegan, I just started feeling, I mean, I feel better than I ever felt. It wasn't like I felt, you know, horrible or bad, but this diet really feels good, eating this way. And also I get regular exercise, I mean, every day. When I go into the eye clinic, you know, I see people that are practically blind in there, who've had diabetes not as long as I have. You know, I see people, you know, you see people who are blind, you see people who are overweight, you hear about amputations, you hear, you know, there's all kinds of really horrible things that people with type 1 diabetes, you know, who don't have it well controlled and who are eating an unhealthy diet, that happen to them. And I haven't had those problems. And I don't think that that's just unique to some genetic thing of me. I think that that has to do with, with diet and exercise. I just can't emphasize enough how important, certainly for anybody who has type 1 diabetes, eating this way is. I mean, I think for everybody it's important. But it really makes a huge difference in someone who has type 1 diabetes' life. And certainly with type 2 diabetes, with type 1 diabetes, you have to take insulin. I mean, your pancreas doesn't work. You can't eliminate insulin. That's just the fact of life. But you can keep the amount of insulin that you take down. But for people with type 2 diabetes, I mean, the information is out there, the studies are out there, that it can be completely reversed. And so for anyone with, and that's what we have a epidemic of, is type 2 diabetes. And those people, you know, from everything that I've read and understand, you know, could completely eliminate their type 2 diabetes simply by going on, you know, John McDougall's diet, which is a great way to eat. I mean, people don't understand. People think, how can you eat, how can you, you know, not eating this or that, you know, oh, I love cheese, I, you know, all this junk, okay? But when you eat this way, it might take you a month. If you stick to it for a month, that cheese addiction goes away, you know. And then if you actually, another piece, which isn't so much part of McDougall's thing, but if you do a little research about what happens, factory farm animals and that whole side of things, the animals that are, how they're treated, it's so nauseating that all you have to do is think about that. If you ever thought about, oh maybe I want to have some chicken or something, all you have to do is think about how the animals are treated, and you don't want to go anywhere near that. You know about the antibiotics that are going in. So, you know, it's so important. You eat this way, and you really, you don't want to eat any other way. It's not like it's a, I don't get to. No, I'm lucky. I get to eat this way. I get to have, I mean, the vegetables are delicious. You know, beans and rice, and you know, you can make you know, tortillas with beans and rice, and you know, a little hot sauce, a little, make a tostada that's healthy and delicious. It's just, you know, it's just a great way to eat. There's lots of different food that you can eat too. People say, what do you eat? I mean, there's a zillion ways that things that you can eat that are healthy, that are vegan, whole food, plant-based foods.